Hello everyone, Bob Razzulli, Orange County, California. I'm here again with another short video about the answer to the, one of the questions that I get from my YouTube channel audience, from my website audience, and also from some of the students that I have from I4I Academy. And the question is that some individuals get trouble and struggling to learn and understand API 510 material. It is like API 572 or ASM Section 8 Division 1, API 510, API 578, ASM Section 9, ASM Section 5, and others. So the people that having a problem to reviewing these documents, even though APRP 572, which is very basic and self-explanatory, they probably have limited industry experience, but they got eligible for exam. So what they should do when they review any of these documents or contents, and then they don't understand or they're having some problem to comprehend? The answer is that API RP 577. So API RP 577 is a recommended practice and published by the API, and it is part of the API 510 exam. And the topic and the title of the recommended practice is welding metallurgy, but it's not limited to the welding. It's very self-explanatory documents and covers all kind of materials, explains about the materials, what is the carbon steel, what is the stainless steel, what is the alloy steel, what is the hast alloy, what is the nickel alloys, aluminum, and everything, and talks about the material properties, and then welding, different process of the welding and welding metallurgy, also about the non-destructive examination, and in a very, very basic and rudimentary way explains all the NDE techniques like liquid penetrant test, magnetic particle examination, radiography testing, ultrasonic testing, and goes to the advanced NDT and covers all of them in a very basic language. I've tried this and I advise to these individuals that have some problem and struggled with the API 510 material and ask them to go and put all other the contents and standards and recommended practice aside and just focus on the API RP 577 and review that for a week. And then they came back and said when they go back and now they review the API RP 572, they understand, they comprehend, the same for API 510, the same for ASM Section 8 Division 1, and the same for other standard like ASM Section 9 or ASM Section 5 or other RPs, API 578. Because for those kind of individuals that have a limited industry experience, this API RP 577 makes a foundation for them, a concrete foundation, a firm condition. Then they can build on this foundation their knowledge, like start with the API RP 572 and then go to the ASM Section 8 Division 1 and then go to the API 510, Section 9, Section 5. Because API RP 577 talks about everything a little bit in a very simple and basic language. Then this is not for only the newcomers or the people that have a limited experience in industry. It might be useful for everyone. You know, I advise to anyone, if you are needing to refresh your some of the industry knowledge, go first to the API RP 577 and refresh everything, and then come back and start from RP 572 and Section 8 Division 1 and API 510 and other codes and standards that are included in your API 510 program. Guys, don't forget to subscribe in our channel. I'm uploading a single video every day and updating you guys about what's new in API 510, 570, 653 exam, and also for CWI endorsement courses. Thank you for your kind attention and listening to and watching this video.